Let's see our inequality. We have absolute value of x over 5 is greater than 1. The sign greater, it means we have to use the second rule. So we will split our absolute value bars to two inequality. So it will be, let me copy this example first, absolute value of x over 5 is greater than 1. So we will have x over 5 is less than negative 1, or x over 5 is greater than 1. Now we have to solve these two inequalities. I will multiply both sides by 5. 5 and 5 will cancel, and we have x is less than negative 5. Now we have to solve the second inequality. I will multiply by 5, of course, to reduce this denominator. 5 and 5 will cancel, and we have x is greater than 5. Now we have to draw number line. X, we have to find 0. Negative 5 will be on the left side of 0. 5 will be on the right side. We have sign less than. It means negative 5 is not included. The same will be with 5 because x is greater than 5. Now we have to find the value x is less than negative 5. The number less than negative 5 we have on the left side of negative 5. It means we are going to negative infinity. And the value greater than 5 we have on the right side of 5. We are going to positive infinity. Now we can write our two intervals. First will be from negative infinity to negative 5 plus the second interval from 5 to positive infinity. Now, like always, we can check if this solution is correct. First, I will choose the number from the first interval. For example, x equals negative 6. Now, I will copy our inequality. We have absolute value of x over 5 is greater than 1. I will replace x by negative 6. So we have absolute value of negative 6 over 5 is greater than 1. Absolute value of negative 6 over 5 will be positive number, and we have improper fraction. We can change to mixed number. It will be 1 and 1/5 is greater than 1. So this inequality is true. So it means the first interval is correct. Now we are going to the second. We have to choose one number from this interval. For example, x equals 10. So we have inequality. Absolute value of x over 5 should be greater than 1. So now I will replace x by 10. We have 10 over 5 is greater than 1. Absolute value of 10 over 5 is 10 over 5. And 10 divided by 5 is 2. 2 is greater than 1, of course. So our second solution is correct too. So we can write this is our answer.